Hello everyone, thank you for joining in. It's the last day of the competition here at the ISSF World Cup in Granada, Spain 2024. We have great competition behind us, juniors and seniors in finals. Many interesting turnovers or almost turnovers happened. All the live stream finals are saved up on the official YouTube and Facebook channel, so you can check that out anytime. But now, we're ready for the 10-meter air rifle men's event, and that's going to be the first final of today. My name is Martina Lucic, and I'm your commentator for this ISSF event. And joining me today is a junior world champion of 2018 in Changwon. He won his first World Cup medal, a silver, last year in Baku. Hriday Hazarika, welcome. It's nice to have you as a guest.
Thank you for having me. It's a great pleasure.
How was your qualification today? What would you say? Was it a strong competition to get into the finals?
Well, it was. The scores were really high, and it was fine. I learned a lot, and it was difficult. The results maybe not the exactly way I expected, but I'll get back to it again.
Well, you are a very young athlete, just almost fresh out of the junior category. How is it different for you shooting among seniors? Do you feel the difference between the junior competition and the senior competition?
Well, definitely. There are lots of difference, specifically with the results. And for those results, you have to be more concentrated, more disciplined, and more focused, basically. So I feel it's good. The competition is good, but, a lot of work.
A lot of work, as everybody always says. We just saw the air rifle over here. You told me right before we started, you actually started shooting pistol before rifle.
Yeah, I started. For the very beginning, I went to a range and they gave me the pistol. And I started with that for 2 weeks. And then I kind of shifted to rifle after that.
And it turns out it's a good thing you did. One World Cup medal already, and at such a very young age. But these are the eight finalists we're going to get to see today in the finals. They are just starting with their preparation. And we're going to get to meet them a little bit up close. Some of them we've seen in the finals already in the mixed team event yesterday. We're going to see how it goes for them today. What do you usually do in sighting series and preparation? How do you prepare yourself for the finals?
I just, get used to the feeling, the crowd, the whole situation, what's going on, and try to find the perfect way, the alignment and all the technical things that I have to do, and just, shoot in the sighting shots, and just, be ready for the finals.
I guess everybody is doing that right now. This is Edson Ramirez Ramos from Mexico, 23, one of the youngest ones. This is his second final at the World Cup ever. He was actually eighth in Rio last year, so we're going to see what happens with him today. On firing point B, it's going to be Eduardo Bonazzi, also very young, 21. He won the eighth place in the Rio World Cup as well. It's a different discipline. Some of them are shooting 50 meter, three positions. Some of them are 10 meter. And this is Petr Gorsha, who we know very well from the 50 meter, three position competitions. The 36-year-old has been to four Olympic Games, and every time getting better and better. He was seventh in the Rio Olympic Games for the 10 meter, and then jumped up to the fifth place in Tokyo in the 50 meter, three position competition. He's won three World Cups in his career in individual events, in Rio in 19 and then again in 22 and back in 2016 in Baku as well. Maximilian Dallinger, we've seen him win the gold medal yesterday in the mixed team with Dana Jensen, the 27-year-old from Germany. Has one individual medal from World Cup competitions, and it's a silver from Rio last year in the 10-meter air rifle event. This is none other than Jiří Přivrácký from Czech Republic, the 22-year-old last World Cup's gold winner in Cairo weeks ago when I was having a great conversation with Mary Tucker in the final. He's won four World Cup medals, all in 50-meter three position. And it looks like we have some experts here today on the 3P in the 10-meter final. Ole Martin Halvorsen from Norway, 24. He's got one World Cup medal, a team bronze in the 50-meter three position. This is his third final in a World Cup. He hasn't made it to the podium yet, but this might be his first chance. His chance. He was first after the qualification, 633.9. I think we all know István Penny of Hungary, the 27-year-old who won his 27th World Cup medal yesterday in the mixed team event, winning a bronze with Esther Meseros. He's opting for his 28th today. We'll see. He's won four World Cups in individual competitions, mostly in the 50-meter three position event, but we frequently see him in the 10-meter final as well. He was fifth in Tokyo as well, so he's adding strongly to the competition here. Martin Strempel of Austria, he was second after the qualification. The 39-year-old was fourth in Rio last year, and then again fourth in Cairo at the very beginning of the year. This is his next chance for the place on the podium, actually. He's got a gold medal in the team and a silver medal in the mixed team event in Jakarta last year. And looks like that's all of them perfectly and just in time. So Hride, you've been in the finals with some of these guys here.
I've been with Martin and Istvan. They're really amazing, you know, they're strong competitors. Just like you said, you know, they've won multiple medals and, you know, they're really great to, you know, compete against each other.
Yeah, we can see it in the world ranking. They're right over there with your teammates, actually, Panvar and Patil and Babuta. I mean, how is it coming from a nation that's creating so many great, great athletes in the last 10 years, I would say?
Well, it's quite tough, you know, our Indian nationals and all are, they're really tough competitions, and we have to, like, the entire year we have to be really concentrated, and well, it's really amazing.
I'm sure it is. Well, we met the athletes a little bit now in the preparation time, but it's time for the audience here in the final hall to meet the athletes as well. But for that, Hride, I want to ask you, what is it like deciding the quotas in India? Is it a stressful process?
It is kind of stressful because we have to play the Olympic trials just before the Olympics. And after that, we'll know who will be in the team for the Olympics. So till then, we are hoping that you know, not everybody can play those Olympic trials, only 5 to 6 people can play, so we still don't know yet who will be there just after the ranking.
Yeah, we're still gonna have to wait. That's in many different countries. This is happening mostly with the countries who are having many, many athletes at such a high competitions, winning many medals and being in the finals, but in smaller countries, usually the athletes who win the quota go to the Olympics. So it's definitely a different kind of a situation and experience for these athletes. So Jiří won a gold medal in his last World Cup that was in Cairo. Do you think coming in to the finals today, he has maybe some advantage amongst everybody else?
I mean, definitely, but he can prove himself again by winning the gold here today. But I see him being focused because he won, I think he won a silver or bronze in the World Cup finals last year. He's right now in a great form. Hopefully he does great in this final.
We have a mixed team gold medalist. We have a mixed team bronze medalist as well. This is István Penny. He was shooting with Esther Meszaros yesterday. How is it potentially shooting two finals in 2 days? Does it get to you? Is it hard to do it?
It does. I would say at the end it does, but it's fun. It's amazing, and you know, specifically the mixed team. You know, it's really different than the current format. So it's all about, I think, how you manage it. So at the end, I know everybody. Two of them are here today who won gold and bronze yesterday. I think they know how to handle it.
Yeah, let's see the officials as well. Marie Ladouche from France is going to be the jury in charge. It's always nice to see some ladies in the finals hall as the officials. Mr. Agapito is the chief range officer of Spain. He calls on all the commands and makes sure everything is right on time. Once again, these are the eight: Mexico, Italy, Croatia, Germany, Czech Republic, Norway, Hungary, and Austria. And I have to say, for instance, Martin Strenfel, he's been in two finals in the last year. He was fourth in Rio, and then coming into the first final of this year in Cairo, he won the fourth place again. Do you think that creates a little bit of a pressure for him?
I mean, sometimes fourth is really disappointing, you know, just tiny margin from the bronze medal only. I don't think so. You know, I think it motivates you, kind of, you know, come back even stronger in the next competition, and I think that's what he's doing right now.
Well, we'll definitely get to see that now. We're going to start with the two series of five shots, after which we go on to the real deal, the single shots, and the elimination process after each two for the lowest ranking finalist, of course. Sometimes we get a little bit more of an excitement with some shoot-offs happening as well, but can you tell me the difference when you're shooting single shots and when you're shooting these five shot series? Is it any different?
Well, I mean, most of athletes who I'm talking to whenever about the finals, they say like these five shots are the most important because they're the starting. And you know, when you get a good start, you don't need to worry that much about the single shots. So I think that's the main difference. You know, it's kind of a series and it's single shots, and the crowd is always, you know,
yeah,
you know, they're feeling it more on the single shots than the five
absolutely.
Shots.
Absolutely, we do have some great shots right now from Maramirez, a 10.7. Bonazzi started with a 10.5. Gorsha as well, a nice 10.9 from Privraski. That's his second shot, and he is right there in the center of the target. Let's see Penny coming into a 10.4, and Strenfel started off pretty nicely with a 10.6. So 633.9 was the top score. Would you say that it was a good score in the qualification?
Well, I'd say yes. It's a really good score, and I think that's like a confident booster for the finals.
So I usually think or say, well, the 10.5 or above is like a good shot. Anything below that is a little tricky. Would you agree?
I would definitely agree with that. Because below 10.5, it's, you know, kind of difficult. You know, especially when when everybody is shooting these high scores, anything below, it's difficult.
Yeah, absolutely. Look at Privraski. He is definitely there in the center of the target and taking the lead. As we already mentioned, he is coming to his second World Cup in this year, in this Olympic season year. He's already got one gold. And now look at him. He's at the top. .10 from Gorsha put him up on the third place. Whoever shoots a really good score, like a 10.8 or 9, even a 7, you can really see the change in the ranking immediately. And as we move on, those things start changing a little bit less. They kind of establish themselves in the rank, and then we know where they are. But yeah, when the scores are so tight, it's really interesting to see what happens with every shot.
When you have a series like 53.4, it gives you a great confidence, and wow, it's a really good series.
It definitely puts you up there to the top. Benny is there as well. He did have a great couple of shots as well that we've seen. A 10.9 for Bonazzi to wrap up his series puts him on the third position. 10.7. This is very interesting. Privatsky is already having a pretty comfortable lead of 1.2, and then everybody else is having a very, very tight difference, 0.2, 0.1 there, which means that he is kind of going above and beyond. We'll just going to have to wait and see if he's going to be able to, well, keep that up. What would you do if you were in his situation?
I mean, I'd just continue what I'm doing right now, you know, since I have this many good shots, and I'd do my best to keep my heart rate down. You know, after such, you know, this thing, the crowd also gets excited. Everybody, you know, it gets difficult, but, you know, when you're calm and cool and you just shoot, I think it's all there for.
What do you tell yourself? He didn't like this shot. It was a 9.9. What do you tell yourself in those moments? What's kind of the inner monologue happening to stay cool?
Well, definitely, you know, when you shot something like 9.9 or something, you know, thoughts are coming constantly, you know, I have to do better. You know, I just, you know, just calm myself down, breathe a little bit, and just follow what I'm doing. I think that's what will help you the most in the finals.
Looks like everybody got a bit tenseful. We're seeing some slim tens over here, a couple of nines here and there. And the frequency and the energies really change throughout the finals. And then sometimes everybody's like really high and on the top of their game. And then just there's like a wave of energy and everybody goes down for a minute. And it's interesting to watch that, definitely. Privatsky nevertheless managed to come back into the center of the target and come back and save his place, let's say, at the top still. There then Gorsha and Penny. Bonazzi over here shooting a nice 10.6, which can keep him in the top four. When is usually the point where you can't help it, but your heart starts beating really fast?
I would say the starting and the finishing shots, and especially if you have a shoot-off or, you know, you're tied with someone, you know, just below, and if you're getting eliminated or, you know, or going for the medals. So that's...
Do you follow the scores while you're shooting?
Yeah, I do. I just, you know, sometimes you have to be just sure, you know, what's happening around... you know what the others are doing, and I think it helps. I personally think it helps me.
All right, I know that some athletes don't really like to see what's happening. They kind of get into their zone, but obviously everybody has a different technique, and everybody is individually approaching. Even with the stand, you can see that everybody is standing the same, but it's also there was little small differences with the way that people are the athletes are positioned in their stand. How long did it take you to come to a stand that you're using right now?
Well, I would say since I started, I've grown taller, and that was kind of a difficult thing for me to cope with. But it's changing. I have to change it constantly because, you know, sometimes some things work, sometimes, you know, some things doesn't work. But I would say it took me around one or two years to, you know, just to get a hang of it. What's there?
All right. Penny finished with a 10.2. He wasn't too happy about it, but he seemed like he understood what happened there, when sometimes that matters a lot as well. 10.7 from Gorschein Strempel. Finishing with a 9.7. We didn't get a lot of reaction from him, but definitely not the best, as it made him fall down to the sixth place. But still, it's a small difference between Strempel and Ramirez Ramos here in the fifth place. Gorsha and Privratsky are sharing the top now. 0.6 of a difference with Bonazzi in the third place. Do you think it's going to be an interesting finals when you can see that the two top athletes are tied after 10 shots?
I mean, one thing I've seen in every final, it's anything can happen at any moment.
Oh, yeah.
You don't know what will happen in the next shot. But I think it will be a close final, and I think everybody will enjoy it.
Absolutely. It already is a close final. It was close in the beginning. It kind of stayed like that, even though usually it happens that the differences begin to be a little bigger as the shots move on. But looks like this one is going to be a pretty tight one, and the scores after qualification were pretty strong. We're moving into the single shots now, so maybe somebody is going to have a moment of their heartbeat getting stronger. We're going to see that in the shots, maybe. Let's see. Strempel with a nice 10.8. Yeah, things are a little bit more tenseful. Some slim tens here and there. Alvesten with a 9.9, but Privratsky and Strempel definitely stayed in the zone with the nice, strong tens. Point 0.4 of a difference between the top two now. That's definitely still how you said, anything can happen. 0.4 is not such a big difference.
You know, you just need a one shot, you know. Somebody can have a bad shot and the other person might have a good shot, and the whole ranking will change up.
Yeah, definitely depends on when you're standing there. It does depend on what you're doing and what everybody else is doing at the same time. We can see that even more in the mixed team events, where each round is kind of up for itself. Here you do tend to have everything that you've done so far be relevant. So you know how they say, every shot counts. Ramos again with a slim 10. We're seeing some better shots. Gorsha, Privratsky, Halvorsen. Stallinger wasn't happy about that. And there is the Norwegian Ole Martin Halvorsen. He was in the danger zone while we were kind of focusing on the top of the rank. And the first elimination is over. If you were in a World Cup in the finals and you went out in the eighth place, what's the feeling?
I mean, it depends upon what type of final I had. Maybe I didn't shoot really good, but my coaches will be there sitting. They'll be giving me inputs, and I'll give my inputs what happened, and we'll have a common goal and figure out for the next final. But most of the time, I'm really disappointed with myself. Whenever I'm eighth, you know, it's like, everybody loves to win, so even I want to win, but it's not possible every time.
Of course, especially when you're surrounded by such strong athletes who have been in big competitions such as the Olympics, even more than just once. Let's look at Privratsky's stats over here. He's been kind of up and down as well, but it didn't put him away from having that first position still. 0.2 of a difference. Dellinger should say 10.1 again and not too happy about it. You can see that he's been having a bit of a struggle in the last at least two single shots. And he doesn't really have a lot of space for mistakes. He is in the seventh place in the danger zone, as I like to call it. 1.3 of a difference. All right, so if you were in the seventh place and the difference was so high, would you still be able to have some hope that you'll stay?
Definitely, I would just, you know, do what I do best, and I'll just try to shoot a high 10, and hopefully the other shooter, you know, messes up or do something. So that will be the best thing. But, you know, the level what they're shooting, I don't think that's going to happen right now, but we never know.
We never know. Let's wait and see. 50 seconds on the clock. Yeah, that Dellinger has definitely been somewhere between the slim 10 of 10.0 and a 10.5, which is something that is not going to keep you in the final of this high competition. Stanfall still to shoot. Taking a bit of a longer rhythm and shoots a 10.6. So it's going to be a seventh place for Maximilian Dallinger from Germany. Mixed team gold medalist of yesterday. Today, wrapping up in the seventh place. Surely he's going to be happy with the World Cup overall. The gold medal in the mixed team is very great.
I think yes, because I've seen him shooting 50 meters and he does really good there. I mean, coming to 10 meters and, you know, having a good qualification and, you know, having a good finals and winning the mixed team gold, I think he'll be happy about it.
Many of these athletes are actually in the 10 meter and the 50 meter three position. How are you with the 50 meter?
Right now I haven't started, but I'm planning to start in the near future.
Yeah, you can see that that definitely is. I mean, both of the rifle disciplines are very technical, so it can really translate very nicely. As we can see, many of these athletes, Pertar Gorsha, Iston Penny, even Yuri Birevski, have been very, very good in the 3P, winning even more medals at World Cups and more golds at World Cups in the 50-meter events than 10-meter. But you can see them getting ahead in the 10-meter as well, definitely. Not.
I mean, they're shooting amazing, you know.
Exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
2 10.8s,
wow.
And a 3 10.7.
Look at that! This is a round. Now this is a round. I would even be free enough to say that this is the best one yet. Crazy good results over here in this round. Pribratsky is still holding that lead. Ramos down there in the red zone with Martin Strempel as well. Slim differences still. Bonazzi is holding the third position.
I mean, it's definitely possible.
Half a point between the two guys at the bottom. So we can't really say right now. And there's even a slim difference between him and Penny and then Bonazzi as well. So I would say Penny and Bonazzi are kind of finding themselves in the orange zone, while Ramirez and Strempel might be in the red zone. So we're going to see. Shooting a 10.0 is not really helpful in this moment for the Mexican. A nice 10.7 for Gorsha. He's in the second position there behind Privratsky and taking over the lead now even. Edson Ramirez Ramos of Mexico, the 23-year-old. This was his second final of the World Cup ever. Last time he was eighth. Now he climbed up to be the sixth. So definitely it is an upgrade. But that 10.0 showed us that he was definitely stressed, holding himself down there in the red zone and finally leaving the finals sixth placed. Interesting top of the rank, would you say?
Yeah, definitely. No, just 0.1 and we cannot be sure. I wouldn't place my money on anyone right now.
1 point of a difference between Pribratsky and Bonazzi, so that's kind of when where the finals is divided into two. It's looking like a duel between Gorsa and Pribratsky and then everybody else there, but there's still time to even change that. So let's not jump into conclusions just yet. Penny has been shooting stably and then climbing up, which definitely helped him to stay in the finals so far, shooting better and better scores. Oh, gosh, to a 9.9. Pribratsky is taken over. That's not a surprise. With a 10.7 next to Gorsha's 9.9 to a bit of a more comfortable difference. And now, yeah, definitely the whole situation is changing.
For Martin, it will be difficult after the 9.5.
Yeah, looks like the tension got to him a little bit. And as we mentioned in the beginning, he has won fourth place two times now at the World Cup, and surely he would like to be in that podium finally, but now it's looking pretty hard for him. He does have a bit of a slower rhythm. When do you like to shoot in the finals?
I'm a bit near Martin, maybe a little bit quicker than him, but I'm also towards the slower rhythm.
Let's see him as he shoots the last shot in a 10.8. Best one of everybody. Not enough in the end, nevertheless, but he did go out with a bang. If you have to go out, it's good to go out with a bang.
I mean, sometimes, you know, you do your best, but the other people are just better than you. This is the thing about shooting.
Of course, it is the day that you get. And, well, we've been seeing him more and more in the finals. Hopefully, he's going to make his place up to the podium at some point, but it's not going to be today. The Austrian goes out of the final of the ISSF World Cup in Granada 2024. We are left with half of what we started with. Pribratsky at the top, Gorsa and then Penny, and Bonazzi.
I think these are the most difficult shots right now.
Oh, yeah?
Because, you know, there will be one person will be leaving on fourth, and the other will go for the bronze medal. Mm-hmm. So I think the heart rate will be at maximum right now.
It would be, and it could be a hard one for Bonazzi as he is the youngest here. He's only 21.
I mean, but he shot a 10.9 right now.
Looks like he's working good under pressure. This is his second final in a World Cup. And in Cairo, he actually missed the finals by one place. He was ninth. So this is like a really nice chance. Now he got the opportunity to get into the finals. And it looks like for now he is really taking that taking that opportunity.
A 0.1 of a difference.
I mean, look at that. 0.1 of a difference for the three places on the podium. And the one place nobody really likes, let's be honest. 0.1 and 0.2 between Penny and Gorsa, which means it can be any of the three, actually. Oh, you can feel the tension in the room for sure.
I mean, my heart rate is increasing right now.
Yeah, I can imagine what happens to them as well. 10.2 for Bonazzi. Ow, got a shot out into a 9.2. That's going to be the end for the Croatian. Let's make some noise for Petar Gorsa. The question was who's gonna have to. Everybody had to take the pressure, but you know, pulling the trigger in the wrong moment, and that's what happens. Fourth place for the Croatian, Petar Gorša, the 36-year-old. He's got 12 World Cup medals in total. This would be his 13th if the destiny was that way today. But fortunately for Petar, this time it's not. But it is a Olympic year. He's been to four already. Might see him.
He's definitely a really experienced shooter, and he's been to India a few times, and a lot of people said he's a really good guy, and
yeah.
And you know,
he is
amazing coach also.
Yeah, him and Miran Maricic are shooting together as well, and you can see that both of them are really, really great, especially in the last year or two. We could see a lot of great results from Miran.
Both of them were in the Olympic finals, and they did really good.
Yeah. Great guys, but let's see about the guys we have over here. Privratsky, who is holding the lead, shot a 9.8, which means some tension is getting to the Czech athlete as well. 0.6 of a difference, though, still. Coming in from the last World Cup with a gold. Now he is definitely again a medalist.
I mean, he's in form right now, and I think he'd love to continue that in the upcoming competitions also, and hopefully till the Olympics.
Yeah, so now he's in a really high form. How long can you hold that high form?
Well, it depends, because sometimes you're in that form, but some other shooter comes and he's doing even better than you. But I would say you can stay there for. It's really hard, you know. It depends upon shooter to shooter.
Oh, nice shots from Bonazzi and Penny, and it looked like. It really looked like Privratsky thought that this is going to be the end with that slim 10, but even though Bonazzi had a 10.7, it's going to be a first medal for the 21-year-old who last time lost his chance to be in the finals, to come in to the next finals of the next World Cup and win a bronze. Would you be absolutely exhilarating and proud of yourself if that happened?
I mean, definitely, yeah, because, you know, he's just into the seniors, and he already won a medal. So I think it's going to help him a lot in the future, and hopefully we'll see him again.
I am sure we will, and look at that. In the end, something that was happening more or less throughout the whole final, the 0.1 of a difference has stayed yet and still. And I'm sure these two guys are not finding themselves in a duel for the first time ever in their life.
I mean, a Penny, after those two brilliant 10.7, he just took the lead out of, you know, he was in third place, now he's in first. This is the thing about air rifle specifically, you never know.
Absolutely. Two experienced athletes. Two great athletes. Penny is still holding that 10.7, but Privratsky, what a moment. 10.9 takes over the lead.
But again, we are here with 0.1 of a difference again.
Yeah, only 0.1 of a difference still. I'm not going to call it, but this might be a final that ends in the shoot-off. But I don't know, but
I'm hoping for that.
You are? You love a good shoot-off, huh?
Yeah, definitely. Decide who takes the gold medal for the next
competition shot. Load. Now, this is a high, tenseful moment. I'm sure that the heart rate is going up, hands are sweating, and you need to pull on that trigger in the right moment.
Well,
10.5. Look at that. He held on throughout the finals, and by the end, he had a couple of those moments where it was not sure with that 10.0, but back into a 10.9, and then the solid and firm 10.5 to wrap up the final.
Yeah, he had some difficult moment, but it was a fantastic final. He came really strong, and you know, congratulations to all the winners.
Absolutely. Jiří Prirácký with the gold of Czech Republic, István Penny from Hungary with the silver. He won a bronze yesterday in the mixed team event as well, so Penny is going away from this World Cup with two medals. Surely he's going to be excited about that as well. Well, Hrýdej Hazarika, thank you for joining me. It was really a pleasure having you in the finals and going into the depth of what happens here with you. I hope to see you again.
Thank you so much for having me, and it was a wonderful.
Thank you. Great. Once again, Eduardo Bonazzi with the bronze, István Penny with the silver, and Jiří Prirácký with the gold. Stay with us. We're going to have a quick chat with the winners. Silver medal. This is, yesterday was your 27th, I have to tell you. Today is your 28th medal. How are you feeling in the last, those two last couple of shots shooting next to Jiří?
I mean, it was a very tight final. I think the first few places were really tight, close together. Jiří was, from the beginning, he was in front of all of us. And before the last shot, I mean, before, I think, two shots before the last shot. I could take the lead with 0.1 with 3 10.7 in the rows, but of course here you also shot a 10.9 for the one before the last, and then I mean it was a very tight final. I'm really happy with the overall score, 24 shots, 24 inner tens. I couldn't be more happy, really.
So two medals going from the World Cup. This is the Olympic year. Are you preparing for that?
Of course, definitely. Of course, I think all of us are preparing for the Olympics. So, I mean, it's a long journey. I changed my rifle in November, which was, I think, a very good timing for that. And now I'm finally starting to get used to it, and the Big Tens are coming back. So that was one of the changes what I did before the Olympics. And definitely, I mean, there are a lot of trainings in front of us. Unfortunately, I still don't have the quota, but I'm very good on the ranking points. So I will go on all the World Cups and definitely also to the Rio. So a lot of traveling, just like last year. But I'm up for it. And just 28 World Cup medal in my career. I hope that there will be at least the same amount in the next years.
Absolutely. Congratulations, and thank you for having this chat. I'm going to let you go now and see what I want.
Thank you.
Okay, Jiří Prvácký, gold medal, second time in the World Cup final this year. What's up? How are you doing this?
I don't know. Maybe just a little bit of luck. I honestly don't really know. I think that the differences are so small that everyone tries their hardest, and just I had two good days when it worked well for me, and here we are.
How long can you keep this? So you're in a good form right now, obviously. The Olympics are kind of right around the corner, but it's still a few months away. Do you think you can hold that form until the Olympics?
That's hard to say. Of course, I will try to do that, but you never know. There are many things that can go wrong, especially in shooting and rifle, where it's about precision and every little bit counts. So we'll see.
You had that 10.9 in a very crucial moment, and also a 10.0 in a very crucial moment. Those are two different emotions. How do you handle that in the finals?
Jesus, that's a good question. I try not to focus that much on the score, but more on the process and just taking that shot and mostly aiming and not pulling it out of the 10. Yeah.
What is the process?
Well, for me, it's the obvious, like you have to load, put it in your shoulder, hold. And for me, what works the best is focus just at aiming. That's what works for me. And then the triggering, it kind of has to come naturally. I can't pull it because as soon as I pull it, it goes out. So
many athletes say that. Well, thank you for that insight and congratulations. I'll see you at the podium.
Thank you very much.
So, Edoardo Bonazzi of Italy, your first senior World Cup medal. How are you feeling?
It's very honor, okay, and I'm very happy because it's an year to hard work, and it's the first step for I think an Olympic, and it's very good.
So you had you missed your chance in Cairo. You were ninth. Do you feel like this was a comeback?
Yeah, for sure. Cairo, it's very difficult. The ride is very stressful, but here it's the revenge.
And you made it. Only 21. How are you feeling being so young among these senior athletes that have already been at the Olympics and shooting in really high finals? Do you feel intimidated, or how do you keep your calm?
Yeah, I feel a little intimidated because in the past I see this big from the telephone shooting on the schedule. That's very strange to see in person and to compete with them.
But you made it, and you're among the great ones on the podium. Congratulations once again, and see you at the victory ceremony.
Thank you so much.
Well, that's it for the first final of the day, and we'll be back for the last final of this ISSF World Cup competition. Come back to watch the women at 4:30 local time here in Granada to wrap up this wonderful competition.
Czech Republic goes to Jiří Pribatsky. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Czech Republic. Thank you. Congratulations once again to the winners of the Tokyo Air Rifle Men's event, Eduardo Bonazzi, Istvan Penny, and Yuri Pravatsky. We'll now pause for photographs to be taken. And that will then conclude this event, the 10-meter air rifle men's final. The next final, the final final, on the final day of competition here at the ISSF World Cup Granada 2024, will be the 10-meter air rifle women's event. And the final will start at 4:15 p.m. local time.